This is another problem that we are going to solve today to calculate the acceleration of an object that's moving on a flat horizontal surface with friction under the influence of a non-horizontal force Fa that makes an angle theta with the horizontal or with the x-axis. To see how we got this free body diagram, refer to the video that shows you how to develop a free body diagram under this given information. Make sure that you double check once you have the diagram put together. You double check for the magnitudes. You do a magnitude check, which means mg should be in magnitude equal to the sum of Fa sine theta and normal force, because these forces on the y-axis must be balanced, and Fa cosine theta is greater than Fk because this object will accelerate on the table to the right. Once we have that, we're going to put the equations together, again, based on Newton's second law of motion, F net equals m times a. However, we're going to have an F net x, and we're going to have an F net y. Since the object does not accelerate on the y-axis, F net y will be zero. Since the object accelerates on the x-axis, F net x will be m times a. Now, in order to continue developing these equations, we are going to have to remember that F net is the vector sum of all the forces. Therefore, we need to consider these vectors with their directions. So I am going to pick my positive directions and show it clearly over here. To the right for X and upward for Y. Knowing this, we are ready to put together the equations with the vector equations with their with the forces and their directions. So for F net y, we have 1, 2, 3 forces added together. 1 plus 2 plus 3, and that's going to have to give me a 0. What are those three forces? Well, I have a positive normal force plus n. I have a positive Fa sine theta plus Fa sine theta, and I have a negative mg. Negative mg. When I simplify this equation, I'm going to end up having the following: n plus Fa sine theta minus mg equals 0. And that is my equation for the y-axis. In order to solve for the normal force, knowing that I'm going to need it for the force of friction, I am going to isolate n in here to have n equals mg goes to the other side, becomes positive, Fa sine theta goes to the other side, becomes negative. Now we are going to move on to the x equation. Well, on the x, we only have two forces. So when we put those two forces together as a vector sum, we need to equal that to ma. Well, those two forces will be the positive Fa cosine theta and the negative Fk. When we simplify this, we are going to have Fa cosine theta minus Fk equals m times a. We do know that Fk equals mu k times n, and we do know that n equals mg minus Fa sine theta. So therefore, Fk is going to be mu k times this expression from here. Mg minus Fa sine theta. Now plugging this in here and then in there gives us the following equation: Fa cosine theta minus Fk, but Fk is mu kn, which is mu k times this expression here. So minus mu k times mg minus Fa sine theta, and this should be equal to MA. And at this time, looking at my given, which are M and G and FA and theta and mu K, I have everything except for the TBD, which is what I'm looking for, and that's the acceleration. I'm ready to solve for it. Put M in the bottom of my fraction and this whole expression in the top. Circle, that's my final answer. Make sure that everything in this expression, in this final expression, is in my given. FA is there, theta is there, G and M and mu k are there too. So this is my final answer. Thank you.